Andrea Kay is retracing Alexander's steps through the Western Desert, one of the most inhospitable places on Earth. She comes here because when Alexander passed this way in life, he unwittingly determined what would happen to his body after death. He bound together his future and the future of Egypt. He ensured that when he died, men would fight for the right to build his tomb.
We've got miles and miles of dunes, and it's very hard to navigate here.
Egypt's western desert stretches for 400 miles from the edge of the Nile Valley to the Libyan border. And if it's hard to cross today, it was even harder in the 4th century BC, when Alexander led his men here.
It would have taken him 7 or 8 days on horseback, and without modern maps or GPS to tell him where to go, they just sort of had a rough idea. A small town on the coast, go south about 200 miles.
Alexander was heading for Siwa, the most remote settlement in Egypt. Then, as now, Siwa was an oasis. In this vast sea of desert, it's an island of fertile land, fed by natural springs. In Alexander's time, it was also a sacred place. Home to Amun, the most powerful Egyptian god. In Egyptian tradition, Amun is the ram. He's also the father of the pharaohs. Andrea Kay, an expert on Alexander's legacy in Egypt, is convinced that what took place here was a pivotal moment in the story of both the man and the country. Kings had knelt before Alexander. Cities had fallen before him. But now he asked for an audience with the priests of Amun. The Temple of the Oracle still stands here. Alexander usually traveled with a retinue, if not a great army. But he left them behind as he climbed the sacred path to find the Temple of Akhmuri.
The sun beating down on us now would have been covered over in antiquity. We would have been in a very cool, very quiet, a very secluded place.
By tradition, Alexander stopped at the entrance to the inner sanctum. This is the spot where he is said to have stood one day in 331 BC.
That's a pretty rare thing to be able to say, that someone thousands of years ago was standing exactly in this place. He would have looked in to have his conversation with the god, which would have been a statue, something like the rams that you see down in Karnak. The priests would have been hiding back here in this passageway. And while Alexander spoke to the god, they could hear him.
However this meeting between man and statue was played out, Alexander appears to have left with what he wanted. From this moment on, he was no longer the son of Philip II, king of Macedon. He had a new father.
By proclaiming himself the son of Amun, he is claiming